Allow me to introduce to you Dr. Rajiv Bhanot, the Managing Director of H2O Saver.
Now, as I was walking up, I saw a number of you guys that were having chapped lips, very dry lips. It's very hot outside. You know, the air in here is pretty dry as well. And being a doctor, I've got the perfect solution or prescription for you guys. Have a sip of water. Now, what I just did right here is something that we do every single day. We drink clean, filtered, sterile water. But believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen, at this day and age, this is something that is still considered an absolute privilege. It's a privilege that 2.5 billion people around this planet do not have any access to. If you want to put that in perspective, in a room like this, that would mean that one out of every three of you people would be forced to drink filthy, dirty, contaminated water, much like this, right here. Right, if you take a look at the screen, this is our planet, the blue planet. We've got seven seas, 165 rivers. We've got 300 million lakes, all containing 300 million trillion liters of water. Wow, that is a lot of water. But the cruel irony of the world that we live in is that every single day there are men, there are women, and there are children that are dying of thirst. Now try to understand what I'm saying. We are dying of thirst in a world that is filled with water. If I can have everyone to just close your eyes for a quick minute, I want you to imagine you're a mother of four living in a remote part of this world. Every week, your daughter, your son, your husband, your neighbor is falling sick. It was less than a year ago that your four-year-old son died in your arms because he suffered from severe diarrhea that caused him dehydration. Now, you were unable to walk that 5 days to the nearest medical facility that could have potentially saved your son's life, and you cannot forgive yourself for that. Now, you ask yourself, what is causing all this suffering? Could it be the water that you're consuming in your village? Now, water does not come easy for you. Every single morning, you and your two daughters, one age 13, the other age 9, have to trek and walk for 6 hours to get to the closest river to collect water. Now, mind you, the water that you collect is anything but clean. It's filled with feces, it's dirty, and it's muddy. And you bring that water back home, and you boil it, and you pray to God that it's going to be safe for your family to consume. And every single day, when you are taking that long walk with your two daughters, you look at them and you ask yourself, should my two precious little girls not be in school instead? Now, ladies and gentlemen, if you open your eyes, you will realize that this is not a figment of your imagination, but this is reality. This lady up here is Radu, and these are her two children. Now, she lives in a remote village off the coast of Borneo. Radu is not alone in a struggle, by any chance. In fact, far from it. In 46 countries around the world, one in two people today still do not have any access to clean drinking water. Now, this affects people's lives in every way. In developing countries alone, more than half of schools do not have proper clean water and sanitation. And without proper toilets, schoolgirls drop out once puberty hits. And we all know when girls are denied an education, families, societies, and countries as a whole suffer as a consequence. 40 billion man hours are spent every year in sub-Saharan Africa alone to walk and collect water. So every single year, 40 billion hours are spent by people walking to collect water. And most of the water that they collect, because they don't have a choice, is once again filthy, disgusting, contaminated, smelly, poisonous water. Now, what is 40 billion hours? 40 billion hours equates to 4.5 million years. Now, to put that to perspective to you, 4.5 million years, what happened 1.5 million years ago? The first handmade tools were invented. 3.5 million years ago, North and South America was still one continent. And 4.5 million years ago, humans took their first steps. I want to put you forward to another sad statistic and a number, which is 9 seconds. Every single 9 seconds that passes by, an innocent life is lost somewhere around this world. That means every day, 10,000 people lose their lives due to drinking contaminated water. And in the course of a year, 3.5 million innocent lives get lost every single year due to contaminated water. This 3.5 million lives means it's double the population of Kuala Lumpur. Now, what if we could change all of this? What if we could turn those 40 billion hours into 0 hours? What if we could prevent 3.5 million people from dying every single year? What if we could change the lives of every single Radu that lives on this planet? Let's just try to imagine for a second, what would Radu's life mean if she had clean water accessible to her? Now, first and foremost, Radu's family would be in a much better state of health. Radu's husband would be able to go to work and get a stable income for the family on a monthly basis. Radu's 2 kids would be able to attend school. Was it not Nelson Mandela that said that education is the single most powerful weapon that we can possess? And Radu, well, she would be able to get a second job for the family if she wants to add on to the household income. She would be able to nurture her kids a lot better. I know what all of you guys are thinking right now. Well, you know, this is probably asking for too much to do something like that. What if I were to tell you that a solution to water poverty was right here in this very hall? Now, what if I were to tell you that let's dirty the water up a little bit more since it's not dirty enough. That dirty, filthy, contaminated water, much like this over here, could be converted into safe, sterile drinking water, and all you'd have to do is just give a squeeze. Cheers. I've done this a few times before, and people have asked me, have you been sick the next day? Could I have a brave volunteer to come up on stage? Anyone? Excellent. Okay. You can, if you could just hold the glass for everyone over here. So what you have in here is dirty water. It's filthy water. Almost feel like a magician when I do this. This is technology. Yeah, it's not a magic show. He just wants a bit. Should I give him a bit, or do you want him to have half a glass? It's either they really like you very much, or they don't. You know? So all you got to do is to squeeze. Okay, go for it. No. Thank you. Thank you. So over the past 5 years, this is absolutely what we at H2Go have been doing. We have the ability to convert dirty, filthy, contaminated water into safe, sterile drinking water in a matter of seconds without using any chemical additives, without using any electricity, without the need for any ultraviolet treatment. All of this is done at a production cost of less than 1 cent per liter. The cost of half a liter of bottled water, I think, is going for about a ringgit right now. So we do it at a production cost of less than half a cent per liter of water that is being produced. We have been to the most interior rural parts of the world, where basic infrastructure like roads and electricity are simply non-existent. Now, our nanotechnology is incorporated into three products. Our first product is a communal-based solution, whereby one big communal tank can provide 350 people enough clean drinking water for a period of 4 years before the need to replace a single part. Our second product, which is the carry can, has got the ability to provide clean water for a family of five for up to 5 years on a daily basis. And our final product, the bottle that you saw right now, to us, this is the solution to disaster relief operations all over the world. Every time there's an earthquake, every time there's a flood. Now, what is the irony of, you know, a flood victim? They are trapped with millions of liters of water, but people are dying after these natural disasters occur because they do not have any clean water to drink. Governments spend hundreds of millions of dollars every year getting bottled water delivered to these victims when they can give them one of our H2Go bottles. Till today, we have reached and changed the lives of 1.5 million people worldwide. Now, while this seems like a huge number, there are still 650 million people today that are trapped in a world where clean water does not exist. 1.5 million out of 650 million is less than 0.2%. To us, it means that our journey has barely begun. Now, ladies and gentlemen, should this not be the smile that should be on the face of every child? No child in any part of the world needs to be worried and stressed about where he or she is going to get that next sip of clean water. To date, we have worked around the world, and we've worked with governments, we've worked with NGOs, we've worked with corporate entities, we've worked with individuals. Why? Because we believe that nobody should die due to water poverty. It's an absolute injustice, and it's just wrong. It is mine, it is your, it is our collective responsibility to engage with the world. This is all we have. This is our home. Today, we have got technology, we have got resources And we have got the skill to be change makers. The only thing that we lack is human will. Every one of us in this room today, be it a full-time staff working here with Digi, for example, we are all in a position to make a change if that's what we want to do. We are all in a position to work together to save that one life that could be saved if we get to them fast enough. I would like to end this with a quote by Carl Sagan. He is an astronomer and he truly inspires me. Now, Carl Sagan said, "The Earth is the only world known so far to harbor life. There's nowhere else, at least in the near future, to which our species could migrate. Like it or not, for the moment, Earth is where we make our stand." So, ladies and gentlemen, let's make our stand. Thank you.